We're here at Sur La Table in Bridgeport Village, and I'm with Laura. She is going to help us with knives.
Yes.
Very important component of your kitchen. No matter if you're a great cook or you just cook once a month, you need to have good knives.
Good knives make a huge difference. Many people don't have the good knives. They don't like to cook. They think it's just a waste of time. You get the good knives, suddenly you're making, you know, tens of thousands of different items you didn't know you could do.
Right.
So
what is a good knife?
A good knife is having a sharp edge, maintaining your edge, and knowing what fits right in your hand. The knives that I recommend are going to be either a chef's knife here or a santoku, which is a Japanese chef's knife. And then past that, you'd mainly want a paring knife and a really good bread knife. I've brought out a few different brands here. We also have the Global, a paring knife here in the Global.
Now, these are the kinds of knives I have, and I really like them because they fit in my hand well. I don't have big hands, and they just fit really well. Is that...
That's the key. You want it to fit well in your hand.
I'm not sure I hold it right. There's a special way to hold a knife.
There kind of is a special way. What you want to do is you want to kind of pinch it with your thumb and your pointer finger, and then you want to grab here. That's where the knife is meant to be held in your hand.
Almost the base of the blade,
right.
Really.
It is meant to be an extension of the hand, not just an awkward something. When you're holding it back here, it's a lot more dangerous. You're more likely to drop it and harm yourself. And nobody wants to do that.
No. Now, this Japanese knife, I've always wondered about these divots.
The hollow edges. What those do is they create little air pockets, which allow the food to move up the blade and fall off. So you're not stuck there chopping and it doesn't get stuck to it. You're not constantly having to flick it off your blade. It just keeps moving, allowing you to keep moving when you're chopping.
Can you show me what you mean?
Yeah, so let's chop with this slice here. So if we just kept moving, it just keeps moving. It's either going to move
right
up the blade or fall off.
Gotcha, perfect. Nice and sharp. Now, is it true that more people cut themselves with dull knives than sharp
knives? It is true. Yes. Dull knife is more likely to slip when you're cutting something and is more likely to, essentially that, it's just going to slip.
Yeah.
So if you're cutting, you can't get it quite right and you move and...
You force it and exactly.
Wrong way.
But you want to keep all of your knives very sharp. I mean,
right.
That's the key. How do you do it?
With a honing steel.
Okay. Never have known how to do this.
So the honing steel is here. It's not a knife sharpener. It's maintaining the edge. Your knives have little teeth on the bottom, and what they do is they get all smashed and go like this on your cutting board. What you want to do is pull them straight with your honing steel. The way we recommend to do that is just hold it up like this. What you're going to do is you're going to take your knife and place it up by the finger's width from the back to the tip, the full length. Just a few times each side.
Perfect. And that hones your knife.
Every time you pull out your knife, you pull out your honing steel.
Every time?
Every time.
All right. And then if you want it sharpened, you can do that professionally.
Right.
Have those done.
You can bring it to us if you'd like.
Right. Great, Laura. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Now you'll be all set in your kitchen and you could start showing off your knife skills.